Thank you for all the remaining participants. Right, I'd like to go through some data about the Albanian electronic communication markets, especially for broadband, and also some regulatory measures taken from MECET during 2014 and up to now to 2015, and what we foresee for this year. Okay, the main trends for the market for 2014, I think, is the latest trend as the last few years. That is, the market turnover is in decline, also in 2014. So we had a 17% decrease of turnover of the operators, in the, all operators together. While the other services, we have a fixed broadband. There is a growth, growth of the number of subscribers. And also for mobile subscribers, there is a decline in number of subscribers for users of telephony, mobile telephony. But there is increase of usage of telephony services and also increase of usage of mobile broadband or 3G services. Fixed telephony is again in decline also in 2014, following the trend since 2009 or 2010. And also we see an increased usage of bundles of services, which is double play, triple play, and the latest one is also 4-play from Mark Telecom, so mobile, fixed telephony, IPTV, etc. And yes, I was told about the incompatibility of, because Microsoft Office 2010 and 2007, which also shows the importance of compatibility. I think this one of the few slides we made. See that there are about 247,000 subscribers of fixed telephony in Albania, which is a 12% decrease from 2013. While on the fixed broadband, there is 207,000 subscribers, which is a 13% decrease from the 2013. So we see that the fixed broadband connections are nearly the same as the fixed telephony connections. Regarding the distribution between urban and rural areas, the fixed telephony is 95% concentrated in urban areas and 5% on the rural areas, which is similar with the fixed broadband coverage, or say subscribers. While Tirana, which is the metropolitan area and probably 30% of the population lives in Albania, as 41% of all broadband subscribers, fixed broadband subscribers, are in Tirana region. Not Tirana the city, but Tirana region. And the same is 47% for fixed broadband and 41% for fixed telephony services. If you see the distribution by regions, we see that Tirana has not only the largest number of subscribers, but also the largest penetration, that is the number of subscribers for fixed telephony and fixed broadband per population, which is about 12 or 13% for fixed broadband, while there are regions which is very low, which is like Tibur and Bucos, which are in the region of 2%. Before that, we had a slide which shows the, we measure the regarding the technology used in the fixed broadband networks. And the DSL is the dominant technology, where we have about 62% is based on DSL and 27% on cable, while we have 7% on fiber to the home and fiber to the building, and the rest is different technologies. These figures are similar to the European Union average, but with some distinctions regarding DSL, because DSL Albania is mostly is fiber to the node, but not yet VDSL, while in European Union is VDSL with very high speed. And also broadband in Albania is, cable, broadband cable is about 27%. But from cable, only 12% is DOCSIS 3 or NGA cable, While in the European Union, it's, now it's just 80% of cable is on DOCSIS 3. So what we are lagging behind, I think, in terms of distribution of technology might be similar to European Union, but I think the speed from DSL and, let's say, next generation network of especially our telecom and also from cable operators to move the speed, rather speed to be higher, to move the VDSL and also to NGA cable or DOCSIS 3 systems. In general, the broadband infrastructure market, I mean the market in Albania is especially fixed network markets. We have many operators, but at least 80 operators with their own networks. So the competition is more like infrastructure-based competition. But although we have taken measures for infrastructure sharing, use of infrastructure from alternative operators, like imposing of LLU obligations for the incumbent operator, we've seen that it's always about 3 years that the reference unbundling offer is published, and also includes measures for NGA. It's not effective yet because the operators are using their own networks, not just their own backbone or Uber network, but also in their last mile network, they use in their own networks. And also some of the main alternative operators, they have their own network, like cable operators, which are not compatible with the fixed network or LLU or the copper network, copper part of the fixed incumbent. Bitstream access, it was imposed about 2 or 3 years ago, but the price was imposed under regulation last year, and it's starting to take place. If the other slide is... And we see there's a very low infrastructure sharing between the operators. Especially passive infrastructure sharing is very low. That is usage of ducts and also in antennas or masts for between operators. Only 19 kilometers, for example, there are shared, 20 kilometers of ducts are shared between operators. There, I think there is just one contract between the incumbent operator and another operator. So, regarding the measures we've taken on the regulatory measures for the market in 2014-2015, in 2014 we completed 4 market analyses regarding the leased lines, broadband access, including the local loop unbundling, wholesale mobile termination, including the retail mobile market review, and also wholesale SMS termination. For this year, we started and also planning to start fixed telephony market analysis, review again, and also the leased lines on broadband markets, because we feel, although we finished this last year, feel the changes in the market, and also for in order to promote more the infrastructure sharing, passive and also active infrastructure sharing between the operators, and also as we mentioned here before, the measures taken by the government, also by ECAP, in order for the cable and operators on this environmental, not friendly wires in the urban areas. We'll try to measure also this also from to have some measures to be more effective, the measures for Bitstream and also for local loop unbundling, because we last year when imposed the obligations on Altelecom in January, February for leased lines and also for wholesale broadband and local loop unbundling. We tried also to take into account the migration of our telecom network from a traditional PSTN network to NGA network. So the remedies included also measures for alternative operators to have the possibility to access the end users or to access the end users from higher up in the hierarchy of the network of our telecom, like Bitstream. But also can use the local loop unbundling using the passive infrastructure or other infrastructure like leased lines or ducts. So our telecom has since 2012 had the obligation to provide access also to passive infrastructure for local loop unbundling solutions. And also from last year we imposed obligation for leased lines also based on the Ethernet because of the NGA network of our telecom. And also to provide access to leased lines from to connect the MSANs aggregation points with the final MSAN which connects to the end users. And also the Bistrim access used to be an obligation for Artelecom, but the price was not regulated, it was under commercial negotiation. Since last year, it's regulated under retail minus approach, which is the approach also recommended by the European Commission. And the last one, Bistrim access, we have figures from Artelecom, which is figures from Artelecom that show that it's starting to take place. Bistrim access, the operators starting to use this service, with Artelecom providing that's about 1,000 connections until end of March, and also there are two completed agreements between Artelecom and two other operators, and two others ongoing. So we'll say that this summit will make a review again this year of this market, to review maybe not a full analysis, but also in line with the changes in the recommendation of the European Commission regarding these leased lines and broadband markets, in order to have an update and also to find the best solutions for the market to promote usage of infrastructure and to provide high speed and quality service to the end users. Okay, the mobile market analysis we've done in 2004 included the SMS termination and also wholesale post termination, which were measures and also measures for tariff regulation, SMS termination, and also voice termination. On voice termination, we imposed since April 2014, imposed the glide path for towards the reduction of mobile termination charges towards pure lyric using the benchmark data from BEREC countries. So decision was to start since April 2014, and with the market analysis that we've done with the review, decided that the glide path would be very short for three main operators. So by 1st of December 2014, our three mobile operators reached the level of 1.06 euro cent per minute, which is the average pure lyric cost or pure lyric tariff applied in European countries. While for the fourth operators, the Float Plus, this we set the glide path to be reached to this level by 1st of January 2016. Mistake. And also from 1st of July is an obligation for non-discrimination between on-net and off-net charges from four mobile operators, which is also comes as a measure for as an internal non-discrimination after also the competition authority investigations and recommendations for mobile market in Albania. And this just shows the trend of the charges, of mobile termination charges, and the reductions reaching the lowest level, which is the level of mobile termination which in countries that are applying pure lyric mobile termination charges. So for this year, as I mentioned, we have make a review of the fixed telephony markets and also the fixed interconnection charges for fixed networks, and also for broadband and these lines, and also take into account, as I mentioned, the redefinition or reconfiguration of markets, relevant markets, as recommended by European Commissions. And also we just yesterday have published a regulation on passive infrastructure sharing, which is issued for public consultations. And so we say from operators, especially alternative operators, the feedback is very welcome and very important for ACAP in this process, because our products and services, which the alternative operators have more information, and also they know best, but because sometimes with these processes we don't have the necessary cooperation or the feedback from the operators. And as I mentioned, like local loop upbounding has been just in theory, not used at all. Okay, thank you. Enjoy the break.